In this video, I am going to explain how gluteal muscles affect for core stability. I want to pick up three muscles today. First muscle is this one. This is very famous gluteal muscle, right? This is gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus. I want you to focus on its origin. Where does it originate from? It originates from pelvis and sacrum. Basically, it's from pelvic girdle, right? I said it originates from pelvis and sacrum. What do I mean? Okay, this is skeletal model. Gluteus maximus originates from pelvis and sacrum. Basically, it's like this. That means gluteus maximus crosses this joint. This is joint between pelvis and sacrum. This is sacroiliac joint. Sacroiliac joint. This joint is very important for talking about pelvic girdle and pelvic biomechanics. Why? Because if this joint is tight or if this joint doesn't move at all, it affects for pelvic movement. Lumbar movement, and this place is important for pelvic girdle stability. Then, gluteus maximus crosses this such important joint. So, if gluteus maximus gets tight, that affects for sacroiliac joint. If sacroiliac joint is aggravated, that affects for movement of sacrum, lumbar spines, and core area. Does it make sense? Gluteus maximus, that crosses sacroiliac joint. And gluteus maximus partially attaches to this ligament, this wide, thick ligament. This is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrotuberous ligament. This ligament connects sacrum and ischial tuberosity. This is part of ischium. Look how wide and thick this ligament is. This is important for pelvic girdle stability. Part of gluteus maximus attaches to sacrotuberous ligament. Again, what's going to happen if gluteus maximus gets tight? That may tighten up sacrotuberous ligament. This ligament attaches to sacrum. Yep. Tightness of gluteus maximus may inhibit movement and stability of sacrum, plus sacroiliac joint, of course, right? Because of that, gluteus maximus is important for core stability. If you follow sacrum to lumbar spines, there's connection for core, right? This is why gluteus maximus is important for core stability. I want to focus with other muscle and gluteus maximus. Again, this is gluteus maximus. I want to focus on one more muscle. That's this one. This is latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi. And I want you to focus on this white, shiny part. This is origin. This is one of origins of latissimus dorsi. This is myofascia. This is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. This is wide, thick fascia. Latissimus dorsi originates from this fascia. Why am I talking about gluteus maximus and latissimus dorsi? This is right side gluteus maximus. This is left side latissimus dorsi. Right side gluteus maximus runs like this. Direction of fiber is like this. And let's focus on left side latissimus dorsi and thoracolumbar fascia. Its direction is like this. This vector, this direction matches with right side gluteus maximus. Right side gluteus maximus and left side latissimus dorsi direction kind of matches like this. Does it make sense? So, left side gluteus maximus and right side latissimus dorsi, their direction, their vector kind of match. There's myofascial connection, functional connection between opposite side muscles. So if gluteus maximus gets tight, that affects for the other side, latissimus dorsi. Why is latissimus dorsi and thoracolumbar fascia important for core stability? Let me explain that. Thoracolumbar fascia has attachments of abdominal muscles. I want to pick up one muscle. There's deep abdominal muscle. That is the deepest layer. That is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis. That attaches to thoracolumbar fascia like this. This is visualization. Thoracolumbar fascia that connects to transverse abdominis. Let's start from beginning. Gluteus maximus that has relationship with thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia has attachment with transverse abdominis. This muscle is important for core stability and abdominal stability. So if gluteus maximus gets tight, that may affect for core stability via thoracolumbar fascia, latissimus dorsi, and transverse abdominis. So again, gluteus maximus crosses sacroiliac joint. Gluteus maximus partially attaches to sacrotibialis ligament. Then, this muscle has myofascial connection, functional connection with thoracolumbar fascia and latissimus dorsi. Thoracolumbar fascia has attachment with transverse abdominis. Look how important this muscle is. Then, let me go to next muscle. Okay, this is deeper layer of gluteal muscle. I want to pick up one gluteal muscle. This is it. This is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius. This is one layer deeper than gluteus maximus. Why is this muscle important? Because this muscle has so many things to do for hip and pelvis. Main function of this muscle is hip abduction. Hip abduction. But if you look carefully, this muscle can do so many things. Let's say hip flexion. Hip flexion is you bring leg forward. That is flexion. The other way, hip extension. You bring leg backward. Then it can bring hip to internal rotation, external rotation. This is for hip movement. And because this muscle attaches to pelvis, that can move pelvis. Which way? Anterior way. This is anterior tilt. The other way? Posterior tilt. Look at how many directions this muscle can bring pelvis and hip joint, right? So many things to do. Thus, if gluteus medius gets tight, that inhibits hip joint and pelvis. Why is this important for core stability? Because sacrum is in between pelvic bones, right? If pelvis doesn't move, sacrum doesn't move. What is above sacrum? There is lumbar spines. And remember, many abdominal muscles attach to pelvis. If hip doesn't move, pelvis doesn't move. Pelvis doesn't move, sacrum and abdominal area do not move. That makes sense, right? Thus, gluteus medius is freaking important for core stability. Well, let's go to the last one. Last one I want to talk about is this one. This is piriformis. Piriformis. There are many deep, tiny muscles on back part. They are deep lateral rotators. Piriformis is part of deep lateral rotators, but I'm going to focus on only piriformis today. Why is this so important? Thing is, piriformis originates from sacrum. That originates from anterior part of sacrum. Then it runs like this. It attaches to femur. Thus, tightness of piriformis affects for hip movement and sacrum. That's important for sacral stability and movement. Again, what is above sacrum? Lumbar spines. If piriformis gets tight, that affects both hip and spine. I don't say other deep lateral rotators are not important. They are equally important because they originate from pelvis. If they get tight, that affects for pelvic movement, thus that affects for core stability. But important thing about piriformis is that originates from sacrum. So important muscle. So in today's video, I picked up three muscles. First one, gluteus maximus, because its origin is very wide, that crosses sacroiliac joint, that attaches to sacrotibialis ligament. And if you follow myofascial connection, there is functional myofascial connection with thoracolumbar fascia, latissimus dorsi, and transverse abdominis. Then next one is gluteus medius. That's so many things to do for hip and pelvis. The last one is piriformis. This is not the gluteal muscle. This is part of a hip muscle, but this is so important muscle. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.